Well, in all honesty, I thought the performance was probably not as good as it has been in the last three or four. In saying that, we have a stone cold penalty that I'm astonished why the referee doesn't give it. And then obviously probably has to be a sending off. He's clipped him, he's the last man, he's clipped his knee. He's gone past him. And then the killer blow is the guy hits a wonder strike outside the box. And then, as you guys probably obviously saw, there was, I don't know how many chances in that last 10, 15 minutes to equalise or then potentially then go on to win it. And that's probably the frustrating thing, even when our performance is probably not as good as it has been in the past. We're playing the best team in the West, and the boys are completely gutted that they had the chances and and I think the referee obviously had a pretty poor one today.
How did Danny do?
Danny did well. You know, it's his first MLS game. You know, proper start. It's going to be tough for him. You know, it's going to be tough for any player when you come back from 12 months out. You know, everybody's probably got a perception of what they last saw of Danny Koopmans, and he will get there. He just needs hard yards under his belt. And so it was good for him that he got 60 minutes, and he'll grow from that.
Was that the plan, just to give him
50, 60
minutes?
Yeah, just to go as far as he can, you know, as much as he can.
Any disappointment with maybe Donald Henry at the end there kind of losing his head? Could you go a man up if he didn't get sent off like
that? Yeah.
Just an immaturity thing?
Well, yeah, I mean, all of us when we were 20 probably would have done the same thing, wouldn't we? He's trying to protect his teammate. His teammate's just been shoved from behind without even looking, and his instincts as a young 20-year-old is probably to do it. You know, everyone in this room would have probably done the same thing. Is it the right thing to do? No, of course not. We would have had 11 men versus 10. We're on the ascendancy. We're looking strong, and maybe things were different, but. But the one thing is about it, Danell's, you know, disappointed. It was a rush of blood, and hopefully he'll learn from it.
Was Silva broke out of Beltran? Did you see what happened? Because all we saw was Silva gets fouled, and then all of a sudden Beltran's pushing over the ground.
Yeah, I don't know what went on. But again, he lost his head, and we had the advantage, and then through probably Danell's, you know, again probably. Just as you say, probably an inexperienced act. We're back to even again.
There was a lot more wing play today, especially like crosses coming in, passes coming in. Is that something you emphasize now that Danny Koopmans is back in the lineup?
Yeah, it is. He feeds off that, and we knew the system that Real play, and it gives the advantage to. If you can get it wide to our wide midfielders, and I thought they're going to be more, knew that'd be very, very key for us today. And some of the crosses were very good, and I'm sitting here quite astonished that you know, two or three of them went in the back of the net.
And keeping on the topic of the wide players, it looks like Darren O'Dea's pretty much cemented himself as a left back. Is that where you see him playing with Toronto FC in the future?
Well, I mean, as he plays very well. Like I said in the past, he's you know, he starts a lot of our attacks. He can overlap. He can cross very well. We've got good, you know, as you see, good young centre backs, and Stephen Caudle again was man of the match again. He was fantastic. So it's just trying to find the right balance to put the team out.
Is this Caudle's last game?
No, I think. Nope, hopefully there'll be news on that. Hopefully.
There will be news, or you're still working it out?
No, I think there'll be pretty good news. Because I think all you guys saw, I think that's probably, if we had a Stephen Caudle at the start of the season, I think we'd be in a different spot right now.
Ryan, any word back from the CSA with regards to working on a compromise?
No, but I bet you they'll probably let us have Danell Henry, that will be the thing.
Playing the top team in the West in a few days to playing the top team in the East, at least as of now, as a coach, what, if anything, do you do differently with only a couple of days to prepare for a team like Montreal on Wednesday night?
I think what's most disappointing today is I don't think the guys, and the guys know it, I don't have to tell them, I don't think everybody played to their potential, as they had over numerous weeks. Even in saying that, you know, not playing to their potential, you know, it's a travesty that we didn't get anything out of that game. So I think they'll be more than kind of eager to get on this field again. And sometimes games can't come quick enough, and I think a game like this will be something the guys will be really looking forward to.
Sorry? Your thoughts on the referee?
I don't think he had one of his best games, in all honesty. And again, this is what I get frustrated about is, and I'm not, it's a very difficult job, but, you know, again, if you don't give a penalty in that, then you have to give Jeremy Brockie a yellow card for diving. It's as simple as that. So every single replay shows he gets clipped, shows the defender knows what he's doing, he's left a leg and he's clipped him. So even if you can't see that, even if you decide not to see that, or, you know, as you say, as what probably happened, he's blinked and missed it, then he's obviously has to give Brox a yellow card for diving. But he doesn't even have the confidence to do that. So by doing nothing is completely the wrong call. That's what's a frustrating thing is everybody in the whole stadium saw it was a stone cold penalty. And as I said, I wonder with these with the inexperienced these referees, I wonder if that was certain other individuals in this league running on goal, and certain other teams running on goal, what the outcome would have been. I'm guessing it might have been a wee bit different.
Was the tone set when he failed to give Lovell Palmer a yellow card for his tackle on Kubermans early in the game and subsequent shove in the face and he gave nothing? Were you worried at that point, or was it in your head that the official might be questionable in the case?
Yeah, I definitely was. I mean, he was, again, I just look for consistency. That's all I ask. I know it's a very tough job. I'm not trying to dig the guy out, but I'm just looking for consistency. And the guy gets smashed from behind. He's just come back from ACL, gets smashed from behind, and he gets pushed. And so, again, just a bit of consistency. So it's a tough job. I wouldn't want to do it, but they get paid to do it, so they've got to be under the microscope as well. Hopefully we'll have Rob back, we'll see how Danny goes. You know, it's he played on Wednesday as well. He had 60 minutes on Wednesday, so, and this Saturday and Wednesday, so we'll see how he is. We'll get them in tomorrow and hopefully get them all ice bathed up and all, you know, hopefully recovered as best we can.
Thanks, Ryan.
Thanks, Ryan.